Hi everyone, today I'm proud to bring you this Ken Tenma deck versus Replicating Perfection. And I'm continuing on my quest to explore the source cards, so I'm using Ixodidae from the latest data pack. So this deck is basically revolving around this card. The history of this deck is that it started in the red faction. I was using Reyna Roja with a lot of chess pieces and other viruses as well. And it seems, I mean, intuitively, you want to play in Anarchs because all of the cards are red in color, Lamprey, Ixodidae, and they synergize well with Fester, which is the one weakness of Ixodidae and Lamprey, is that they can be purged by virus counters. Fester deters that even more. Unfortunately, the more I tried to build the deck, the more I found that I was just dedicating too much deck space to janky combos, and I didn't have enough economy or draw power, or server breaking power. So I switched it up and went to the blue faction instead, and it paid off much better. Why do you want to play in Criminal? It's quite simple. Firstly, you have all the HQ pressure events and stuff in faction. So like things like Feint, Inside Job, and Sneak Down Beta are all readily available to you, and they're so much more expensive to port over the NARC than vice versa. More importantly, I'm playing Ken Tenma, which means that I can leverage on these run events very well, gaining 1 credit each time I play an Inside Job on HQ, a Feint on HQ. A Siphon will get me 1 extra credit if I have Ixodidae on the board, and so on and so forth. And lastly, the most important thing is that Ken has 17 influence, so that definitely comes into play as well, allowing me to splash for more cards that apply R&D pressure, like Medium that you see in my opening hand. He started off with a Celebrity Gift, and I knew that I would be able to fire off my Medium. He only had 1 click left, and obviously any good player will ice up HQ. That's the right thing to do. Unfortunately for him, the 1 Medium in my deck turned up to party in my opening hand. So I got to dig 2 cards. I saw an Inazuma and Yagura Standard, RP Fair. Unfortunately, I couldn't get an agenda off the back of it. You might be wondering, why don't I install the Medium first? Don't play the show gamble. It's quite simple. Almost all RP decks run any PD contract. If I install Medium, I'll be down to 2 credits. If I see an NAPD on R&D, I will cry. So he drew up twice. He drew both of those eyes. So I immediately inside dropped his R&D to see 3 new cards, including a Future Perfect. Well, okay. The Future Perfect came up short. I bid too much. So that does set back my credit pool a little bit. So I continue digging up for cards. Now, his Celebrity Gift revealed to me a Galahad and a Lancelot. That is something to keep in mind. Was there a Lancelot? I'm not sure, but basically he's running Grail Ice. So no more face checking. Ice face checking is out of the question, which is very unfortunate because this deck is very reliant on forcing the corp to res ice. You res ice, I Feint into your HQ, and I emergency shut it down. So that's out the window. So since my money is my economy is pretty weak, I go for security testing. I didn't really want to do this because this will encourage him to ice up archives, and I don't want him to ice up archives because I have a Sneak Down Beta ready to fire along with Lamprey. So he does fire. He does put an ice on archives, the smart thing to do, forcing me to use a Forge Activation Orders on his Komainu. It's a double-edged sword. First, on one hand, it's very annoying to break. My only solution is Alias, but the good news is I can run through with 0 cards in hand if need be. So that is something always on my mind. And as he keeps chaining his hedge funds, Celebrity Gifts into multiple restructures and subliminal messagings, I knew that I couldn't keep his credit pool down, which is a huge worry because this deck is entirely reliant on credit denial. There are no quest complete, so I'm running only central breakers. There's no way I can get through any remotes. So here, I attempt to slow him down. I install Lamprey, make a Feint run on HQ, and emergency shut down his Komainu, which effectively denies him 5 credits, like an account siphon would. The Feint only costs me 1 to play, but it also drains 1 credit from him because I have Lamprey on the board. So far, so good. But he finds his Jackson Howard, which is really annoying. And here's the worst part. I'm playing against RP. I cannot run the Jackson Howard. The only way I can do that is if I face check any of the middle 3 servers, and that won't end well. I know it. He has so many credits, he can easily res a Komainu or any of the Grail Eyes against me, and I'll be toast in no time. So running is out of the question, and a Ken Tenma that cannot run is a useless Ken, basically. So now my only options are draw cards and click for credits. So yeah, this is a horrible matchup for me, and I'm yeah. So much for the early medium deck that didn't net me anything, and I'm in a lot of trouble now. And things got worse. I actually intended to this turn install Sneak Door Beta and Sneak Door his hand with only one card left in my HQ, the account siphon. I can just take the one net damage from Komainu and repeatedly hit his HQ to lamprey him down. But he put a second piece of ice on archives. So it could be a Merlin. Merlin will end my game. So I can't do anything right now but to dig for cards. There's no running available to me. He did the absolutely right thing against Ken Tenma. Double ice all central servers. And since he's running Grail Ice, I cannot run until I find all three breakers. That's so annoying. So basically, he has a huge gaping scoring window now. Until I assemble all three central breakers, there's nothing I can do. I cannot run. There's no option for that. I continue drawing, and the only central breaker I see so far is the Alias. I don't even see a special order. That's really painful. That really puts on the hurt. So now I have to completely ditch my credit denial tactic. All my red cards are going in the heap. No choice here. I need to dedicate the memory space for Passport, Breach, and Alias. So that's three memory units. I cannot find my Desperado, even though I run three copies of it. So that didn't help either. So he's slowly building up his board state, and daily business show is something I definitely don't want to see. He's able to draw through his deck and filter out all the good cards and burying all the agendas that he doesn't want to score. That will be really annoying to deal with. Now, the first thing I want to do here is to account siphon him. I have account siphon to same old thing. That is definitely on my to-do list. That is particularly important because I know RP is incredibly taxing for my deck. Tsurugis and Lancelots are actually very expensive to break with Alias, so I need all the credits I can get, and I need to deny him as many credits as I can, because Grail Ice and Komainos and Tsurugis are all mid-range ice. They cost quite a bit to res, so I should still be able to deny him credits, but after that celebrity gift, man, there are no agendas in there, and so much money. I'm really in a world of hurt. He has 27 credits, how can I siphon him down to zero? That's not going to happen this game, is it? So, basically, now I'm guessing, account siphon is my only way to win, basically. So now I'm thinking of how to get into his HQ. I figured that his innermost HQ ice is a Galahad because of the earlier celebrity gift. If he were to place one ice to start the game off, it would be the Galahad because that has an end the run written on it. So that would deter any account siphons. The outermost ice is anyone's guess. It could be anything from a Lancelot to a Merlin to an Inazuma to another Galahad. You never know. So that is anyone's guess. But I do know that the innermost ice is a Galahad, so I definitely needed a breach. Hence, I spent my first special order getting my Fractal out. In the meantime, he sets up his scoring server, which is looking quite scary right now. But once again, that's out of the question. I can't contest it. I don't even have an inside job to contest it. So yeah, it really is out of the question. I finally find my last breaker, but I'm not going to play it yet because that will scare him into icing up his centrals even more. I'll keep in my hand, I'm going to run next turn. So if he doesn't protect his HQ even more this turn, he is going to be in trouble when I play the account cipher next turn. So what does he do here? He plays Subliminal Messaging and protects his remote, which is a huge mistake. He sees me playing central only breakers. He shouldn't need to place more than two ice over the remote. Two ice necessary to protect against inside job. He doesn't need any more. The third ice was a complete waste. It should have gone in HQ. So that was a mistake that he made during the game. So now he passed the turn to me. Now finally I can apply some aggression. I play the Passport, Siphon. Now, I don't have my Sentry Breaker. Very dangerous against Grail Ice. If he reses a Lancelot against me, I'm toast. He can trash a lot of programs. However, if you notice, I have a clone chip and there's an Alias in my heap, so I'm not worried at all. I didn't want to install the Alias because that would force me to trash my Lamprey, and every credit denied from him counts. So it turns out he doesn't have a sentry on that server. It's just Inazuma into Galahad, which I break for 7 credits. Expensive, but the whole point is not to gain credits. Gaining credits helps. It's kind of offset by the heavy costs of running HQ. Most important thing is that I deny him credits. So I double siphon him, he's down to 12 credits, which is a pretty decent effort. So that is very important, because notice that his archive and R&D ice is still unrest. So now he's down to 9 credits after scoring a medical breakthrough. Again, this is a mistake. He should know that I have no way to contest his remote server. So instead of trying to push out an agenda that does nothing for him, he should gain credits or protect his centrals instead. He didn't do that, so I siphon him once more, having drawn into my second one. So once again, I pay 7 to break it, get 10 credits back, but more importantly, sub him down all the way to 3 credits. Very important. So yeah, and I get a free card draw from John Masanori. Now here he does the right thing. He blows John Masanori up. John Masanori is very effective in terms of efficiency. Blowing it up was definitely the right move for him. I wish he didn't do that, but well played to him. So now that he's down to 4 credits, thanks to blowing John Masanori up, I have a lot of plays open up to me. This really reduces the range of ice that he can rest against me. With 4 credits, he cannot rest a Komainu, so I can safely run on archives for security testing. He shuffled Jackson here, which was a mistake. He accidentally did it, not seeing the security testing token on it. Well, but that's okay. That actually helped him, because my intention was second click run R&D, third click trash Jackson, and last click run R&D again to see new cards off the top of R&D. So him shuffling cards with Jackson was actually the right play. And yes, right now the only ice that I'm worried about at this point is Lancelot, which he can rest for 4 credits. But once again, I'm the clone chip to rescue my alias if that occurs. So this is why clone chip is very important. The other use for clone chip, obviously, is to revive Lampreys and Exodidae's at instant speed right before a successful HQ access. Nothing much to say about that. So basically, I access 4 cards off the top of R&D, no agendas. I don't know what to say. There are no agendas in archives, he shuffled everything by Jackson, there are no agendas in R&D, they must be all in HQ, right? I don't know. Anyway, I successfully denied his credits. At one point he had 27 credits, now he's down to 4 credits. So it makes sense to trash his pack campaign. And his daily business show helps me do a lot of work by pulling out lots of cards, which means that my medium digs will be more and more effective. And this goes back to the early game where he made a crucial mistake. He did not purge virus counters. I suppose he can now purge virus counters, but this would leave him in a very vulnerable position because he's still low on credits. He cannot defend his central servers. We'll see about that. But first, I take my turn. I'm drawing cards desperately. I want to see my Desperado. That is the one card that I need. I don't see it, but I do find the same old thing, which is good for another siphon. So yeah, this deck kind of plays out like Anatomy of Anarch, where you basically siphon lock the opponent. What do you expect? It's a credit denial deck after all. And since no one's playing Sealed Vault, might as well go along with it, no? So, I discard all the useless cards, so this turn I do not place any regression. Very, very tempting to run R&D and archives again, but I decided that I would stave off the regression for one turn. I'll resume next turn. Because next turn, I can potentially siphon him down once again. It all depends on what he does right here. He could install an ice over HQ. That would be a very smart thing to do. But instead, he clicks for credits and goes for restructure. Very, very good move right here by him. This makes it much less appealing to perform an account siphon, especially since it'll take 3 clicks for me to play same old thing and siphon him. So instead, I play the alias straight out of my hand. Lamprey is done. I'm not going to run HQ again. And I security test archives. Now, I know security testing here is not worth it. I know that he's going to rest the Komainu against me, and it will cost me more credits to break it than the return on security testing. The whole point here is to force him to res the commando. That turns on my emergency shutdown. Until now, there was not much worth shutting down. Shutting down Inazuma for 3 credits is very marginal. I want to shut down something bigger, and I force him to do so by resing the Komainu. Next, since he's not on credits, I'm just going to run R&D and access 5 cards. But first, he gets to fire Yagura off, and then Lancelot. So yes, very good that I preemptively installed the alias. So yes, R&D is actually very taxing. That's 4 credits, 6 credits to get through R&D. But it's okay, I'm going to see 5 cards. Jackson, Medical Breakthrough, NAPD Contract, Medical Breakthrough, Clone Retirement, 7 points in 1 turn. 1 click, rather. That's the game. Pretty amazing, huh? Well, to be fair, a lot of my early accesses turned up short, so it was about time that I finally found some agendas. But really unlucky that it all happened so quickly for him. And it was a very key turning point in the game, too. If that run did not net 7 agenda points, the game would slowly but surely shift in his favor because I was running out of steam. You notice that I had 20-odd credits after the multiple siphons from earlier on. At that point, I was down to just 2 or 3 credits remaining. A huge part of that was not having Desperado early on. I have 3 copies of it in my deck. None of them turned up. Very big pity. Worst thing is, I cannot keep a Lamprey on the board because I only have 4 memory units. 3 of them must go to my central breakers. 1 of them, of course, goes to the medium. No space left for credit denial. Otherwise, I'm actually very happy that I overcome one of my worst matchups, which is Glacier and Big Money combined in the same deck. RP is so taxing. Tsurugi's, Lancelot's, and Inazuma's are really hellish to break with central breakers because you need to pump them an exorbitant number of times, and that really costs a lot of money. And the worst, and Caprice makes it much worse. Thankfully, he didn't install any Caprice Nisei's on his central servers, so that helped matters. And a couple of minor but pivotal decisions, such as not icing up R&D first turn or not purging virus counters throughout the game, was what tipped the scales and allowed me to pull out victory from an unlikely position. Thanks for watching and happy netrunning. Goodbye.